Okay, I want to get in one of India's leading authors, Shobha Day. She's listening to what you're saying, Mr. Moro. And Shobha, what the author is saying is that you can't be a public figure and stay away from public scrutiny. Do you believe that there's much ado about nothing? This book should be allowed to come out, even if it has a few comments which are derogatory. It doesn't really matter because Sonia Gandhi is this larger-than-life personality in this country. And what some author says in his book will not shape what a billion people think about this lady.
I completely agree with that because you earlier mentioned brand Sonia, brand Congress and so on. Now, she is a person who's awfully charismatic. People want to know about her. 1 billion Indians have a right to know about her. And I must make my own mission statement, which is that I do not believe in censorship at all. Either we are living in a democracy, we believe in the freedom of expression, we believe in free speech, in which case, if there is indeed something libelous, go to court and fight it out like they would in any other democracy. To kind of bring this sort of pressure on an author, and I must also say that an author has the absolute right to write the kind of book that he or she wants, and the public, the readers, have the right to either accept it or reject it. That's how it works in democracies. But here there are people being more loyal than the Queen or the King and deciding what India will be ready to accept about Sonia Gandhi. I've read excerpts from the book and I think it's very, very harmless. You can call it any definition that you want. It can be an unauthorized biography. You can call it a fictionalized biography. You can call it fiction, non-fiction. It's a very readable, racy account of a very dramatic part of our history. It's like Freedom at Midnight, and we have a right to know. That's it. And we, the people, the readers, have the right to either turn our backs on the book and on the content, or take it in our stride and say, okay, this is one man's representation of a very charismatic, powerful leader, and we make up our own minds. I don't think the Congress Party should get involved at all, and yes, they are making a huge, huge issue out of a non-issue. The book would have probably gone perhaps read by a few thousand people. In any case, it's available on the internet. Whoever is interested has already read it. So what are we talking about? What kind of censorship is this? It's absurd. Doesn't make any sense.
Ravi Shankar Prasad, the Congress says there's nothing wrong in their action because Sonia Gandhi and her counsel are entitled as per the law of the land to take action against any author who's written something they believe is derogatory and defamatory. That is exactly what they're doing. So do you agree with what the Congress is doing? Because they're saying we're entitled to do what we're doing. Someone's written something against Sonia Gandhi. She believes this is defamatory and therefore we're acting against.
Well, my take is entirely different. I don't wish to comment upon the substance of the book written by Mr. Moro. That is between Congress Party and the author. But as public men in a democracy, we must learn to accept freedom of expression and also the freedom of press. I'm afraid this controversy is coming in the wake of recent controversy on the film Rajneeti, where you know that certain Congress members of the censor board forced certain cuts in the particular movie. Now, we have seen the days of emergency when leading editors were also arrested, and what happened thereafter is too well known. And for the sake of information to your viewers, late Narasimha Rao also wrote a fictionalized biography of his own life, which has many, I would say, uncharitable comments. Recently, a leading human rights activist, Arundhati Roy, wrote a book on parliamentary attack in the year 2001, where she said the entire attack was false and it was sponsored by the IB to defame the terrorist. And a respectable company like Penguin published it. Did we seek a ban on it? The people ignored it, as Shobha Day rightly points out. In a democracy, if you are there, you must learn to take things in a stride. And if there is something wrong, trust the vibrance of democracy.
Okay, Salman Khurshid, there seems to be a trend that is emerging. Just last week, Prakash Jha came on this channel and hit out against the Congress for what he called undue censorship. Several scenes from his film were asked to be deleted because there was a reference to Vidwa Le Jayegi Vote Samet Ke, the Congress censors. There were three members with affiliation to the Congress Party who were on that censor board. They wanted the scenes to be deleted. Why is there so much fear and apprehension when it comes to freedom of speech and expression? This is a constitution which was drafted by the founding fathers from your party itself. Why is the Congress so wary and so touchy about these things, Mr. Khurshid?
Well, let's be clear about one thing. I don't know why emergency and censorship is being brought into this. If we are talking about the book, it's all between a person defamed, allegedly, the lawyer of the person, and the author. Where is the censorship? Nobody is imposing any restrictions, bans or censorship. But there is a law. When a lawyer feels that something wrong has been done, he has a right to relief. And relief begins with an issuing of a notice. So, on one side you say too much is being made of this book. I think too much is being made of a lawyer's right to represent a client and to say to someone that you've done something wrong. If that person thinks that he hasn't done anything wrong, he can also consult a lawyer. So what's the problem there?
I don't think the issue here is...